breaking the wall of child obesity. What parents, politics, and vegetables can do. Jean-Michel Boris, EHPAD.
20 years ago, I was in France. The fall of the wall was a great hope for a better world.
I thank the organizers for inviting me to this meeting, and it's a great honor for our team to be part of this special, very special day. And tomorrow it will be, today it will be very difficult to talk about obesity just before the lunch, but I will try to do this challenge. The World Health Organization predicts that obesity may soon replace more traditional public health concerns such as undernutrition and infectious diseases, and the most significant cause of poor health. Children obesity rates are affecting both developed and developing countries. And now, obesity is a public health and policy problem because of its prevalence, costs, and health effects. Obesity is one of the major preventable causes of death worldwide, and on this slide you can see that it's the second cause of preventable causes of death in the USA, just after smoking. Childhood obesity is a medical condition in which excess body fat has accumulated to the extent that it may affect a child's health or well-being, leading to reduced life expectancy. It's not an appearance or norm issue, but really a health challenge. The consequences of obesity in childhood are very high. First of them, emotional and psychological consequences: teasing, stigmatization, discrimination, low self-esteem, depression. Second, life-threatening conditions are associated to childhood obesity: diabetes, heart disease, liver disease, early puberty, eating disorders, skin infection, asthma, and others. Obesity in childhood has social consequences. Again, social stigmatization, disadvantages in employment, more disability leave, less likely to be hired for a job, less likely to be promoted, descendant wedding, limited access to healthcare, etc., etc. The socioeconomic consequences are very important for our societies. And for example, it's at least 10% of all the medical expenditures attributable to obesity in the US today. And obesity is a consequence, but also a source of inequalities. And for example, in developed countries, children in higher social class families were less likely to be obese, and it's the opposite in the developing world, where children in higher social class families had greater rates of obesity. And this is really a global epidemic emerging over the last 20 years. And you can see on this slide the prevalence of obesity prior 19th. And more dark it is, more the prevalence is high. 10 years later and 20 years later. And maybe more important, in the children, the rate of overweight and obesity dramatically increase since the 20 last years. And for example, you have the rates in USA from 15 to 28, in England from 7 to 26 or 27, even in France, in Poland, in other countries, in Spain, in Canada, in Brazil, in China, in India, etc. Why such an evolution? Yes, it's the link with this conference from Michel Brunet this morning. I thank you, Michel. Childhood obesity is the result of an interaction between many, many genetics and environmental factors. And for example, this is one hypothesis, the 50 gene hypothesis, in which certain ethnic groups may be more prone to obesity in an equivalent of environment, and their ability to take advantage of rare periods of abundance by storing energy as fat will be advantageous during times of varying food availability and individuals with greater adipose reserves would be more likely to survive famine, and that's why we are all together in this room today. This tendency to store fat, however, will be maladaptive in societies with stable food supplies like today. Why such an evolution? The growing problem of overweight and obesity in children is due to an excessive energy intake or decreasing energy expenditure, which is related to lifestyle changes, to an energy-dense diet and unadjusted to the needs, and a lower time of physical activity and increased sedentary habits on a daily basis. And I hope that the next future TV will not be worse for this problem. So it's so complex, and numerous factors and sites which in practice influence the choice of activity and foods by the individuals, and you can see a graph which tries to describe all the causes. That means that there is no unique solution to the problem of excess eating and physical inactivity that can be expected. Concerning the childhood obesity management, today it's diet, exercise, relevant behavioral interventions. Today we don't have any medication currently approved for the treatment of obesity in children. There is the weight loss surgery, relies on reducing the volume of the stomach or reducing the length of bowel that food will be in contact with. But all these strategies are low effectiveness. And we need today a massive research development. Why preventing childhood obesity? You have to know that more than 50% of obese children aged 6 today will remain obese later on. More than 75% of obese children aged 10 will remain obese later on. Disorders related to obesity in adulthood are correlated to its severity and length of evolution. And today, life expectancy is 13 years shorter for a young obese adult age 18. Now, what is EHPAD? EHPAD, that's a curious name. The name that means in French, ensemble, prévenons l'obésité des enfants. We could translate together, we can prevent childhood obesity. And the most important word is together. And the EHPAD approach is a coordinated capacity building approach for communities to implement effective and sustainable strategies to prevent childhood obesity. Childhood obesity will be reduced by local environments, childhood settings, and family norms, all being strongly supportive of children enjoying healthy eating, active play, and recreation. And in the EHPAD methodology, we have 4 pillars and goals. The first one is creating a political commitment. If we like to prevent obesity, we need a very strong political will. This is the first point. The second is to mobilize resources, human and financial resources. The third, to have a coordination and support services, and then to evaluate what we are doing with evidence-based and evaluation. And all these 4 pillars are to enable community stakeholders to implement effective and sustainable strategies to prevent childhood obesity. And the target groups are children aged 0 to 12 years old and their families, but also the local stakeholders who can influence childhood settings, food environments, and physical activity environments, socio-economic policies, and socio-cultural norms. And EHPAD is a federative approach. In each country, we have what we call the EHPAD national coordination in link at a national level with an independent scientific committee, with a national institutional support with private partners, and in link at a local level with the mayors or the elected people, elected representative of the community. And these elected people have to nominate what we call the local project manager to manage on the field the actions with a local steering committee and to induce micro changes in the behavior of the population of all these targets. And that what we want to do is the creation of an environment facilitating the adoption of healthier lifestyle by the families. And this is a social mobilization dynamics at the local level, and all these stakeholders, you see here health professionals, but also associations, media, health organizations, school catering, schools, etc., try to send the same message at the same time, the same target, which is the family. And that's why the town is at the heart of the system. And we try to foster multi-stakeholder dynamics into the towns to change the professional practices, to change the environment of families. These are some examples of EPOD concrete local actions. And the first results are very encouraging concerning the evolution of overweight and obesity in the cities. And you have on this graph the first 8 pilot cities in France from 2004 to 2007, and you can see, depending on the cities, a decrease from 10 to 15% in the prevalence of obesity and overweight, and that's very important in terms of health, but also of cost. And today, EPOD is in France involving 226 towns, in Belgium 15, in Greece, in Australia, in Mexico, in Spain, and we have a grant from the European Commission with the DG Sanko to try to develop the methodology in the 27 countries of Europe. It's a public-private partnership, and the cost of the EPOD program is about 1 to 2 euros per year and per inhabitant. And you have to compare this cost to the cost, to the health cost induced by obesity, diabetes, cardiovascular disease. In conclusion, and it will be my last slide, obesity is a global epidemic generating long suffering and individual disabilities. Obesity can be prevented through local, long-term, and multi-stakeholders partnerships at community level. EPOD is a community-based approach based on the creation of an environment facilitating microbehavioral changes toward the adoption of healthier lifestyles by the families. EPOD is transferable as a methodology, whatever the culture and the traditions are. And for the last minute, here is the team in France with Agnès, Christophe, Marianne, Suzy, Julie, Carole, Yann, and you have there the contacts and website. I thank you very much.